My passion for music started from secondary school. I was listening to various styles of music. Obviously, I was not into styles or any particular genres. But then DJing happened in around 1992-1993. And it happened due to the lack of electronic music on the island. Production-wise, I started experimenting with a small drum machine. That was in around 1996. And obviously, I had not produced anything seriously until 1998. And then around 1999, I released the first album, which was obviously an electronic techno album titled Tinnitus. Due to the fact that I listen to various styles of music, I cannot pinpoint any artists in particular. However, I'm influenced by anything, be it a film, an album, whatever can be of any inspiration. When I'm record shopping, being online or at an actual record shop, I do not specifically go for house or electronic music. I listen to a lot of stuff, and basically I buy what I like, and I do not buy music for a particular set or event. I might buy records that I might not play at all, and then I might go back to it after 5 years. I also tend to look for those albums which are totally different to electronic music, however they might just have one track that will fit into what I'm doing today. That will give my sets a particular addition, and there will be more value in the selection. Organizing records in the studio is very time consuming, so I do not have any particular way of organizing them, but I kind of tend to remember where they are. You can say that in the sense of organizing them, it more depends on the time when I used to play them. So for example, when I was a resident DJ at a particular place, I know that that was the selection during those 5 years. Other than that, they might be split according to the country of origin. Like for example, the tracks from Detroit or the tracks from Chicago, those would be separated, you know. And then others, they will be all together, but I know the way they are organized. When I started producing, hardware was the only option. However, after a few years, we started to see the software plugins coming in, and I was a bit confused because I was highly used to the hands-on approach. Nowadays, I like the best of both worlds, so even though I have a lot of hardware, I also tend to use a lot of plugins. At the end of the day, even the hardware is being recorded and manipulated by software. I always had a soft spot for modular synthesis, and recently my latest addition is the Eurorack. I have numerous collaborations, the main one being myself and Melchior Sultana, which started off with the UQ release Memories of You EP. I also have a project with Nathan H called under the title Gauss. Besides, I also have tracks with Woody Aki, with Brian James, and with Jamie Reed. My current releases are the Batte Batte Tribal Roots EP, Inner Shift Music, which includes a track by Gauss, and the Minuendo 7-inch. Coming out soon, in the coming months, there's the Contrast Wax, also on from Gauss. Another Batte Batte coming soon, that will be the Batte Batte number 9. And another 3 or 4 vinyls, which I cannot announce just yet. In recent years, the music scene has improved drastically. There's also a lot of new artists, and a lot of people are listening to a lot of music which they access through the internet. There is no set formula for the selection of music which comes out on Batte Batte. Obviously, new artists who did not have any releases before tend to get the first release as digital. However, on vinyl, I also have artists who did their first release on Batte Batte. There is no set formula, depends on how much I like the tracks and the set my mind frame at that time. To me, TrackScheme is the platform which gathers and combines a lot of artists from different scenes. I like it because obviously out of the artists I never met them, but thanks to TrackScheme, I got to know a lot of bands, for example.